Following almost two centuries of peace and prosperity, after the conclusion of the Great Fiend's War, the Kingdom of Ilion finds itself once again at war. This time it's the Isirian ambition to conquer the known world and rebuild the Sifurian Empire. A decade of war has shown the kingdom to be Isiria's most formidable adversary, with both sides winning and losing their fair share of battles, but none of them gaining a decisive advantage. But in the last 2 years, something in the equilibrium of this long war changed. Although the Isirians kept on conquering smaller kingdoms and territories, strengthening their position in the world, this was not the prevailing factor. Magic was. A different kind of magic. Magic has always been a part of war, for as long as war has existed. But its strength limited, always important, but never a decisive factor. All that changed with a fundamental shift in how the Isirians used it. Necromancy and death magic. With the help of these powerful mages and necromancers, and the superior magic they mastered, Isirians managed in a short time what they couldn't do in a decade, a number of decisive victories that all but wiped the Kingdom of Ilion off the map. The kingdom was left with less than half of its original territory and only a handful of towns, finding itself on the verge of collapse. The Great Iron Chain, a string of fortresses defending the entire north border of the kingdom, is now almost completely lost to the Isirians, with Dag Forum, the largest of these structures, having fallen only weeks ago. Ilion's greatest project is all but conquered. Only Dag Marastir remains standing. But for how long? Tired, weary, driven off their land, the Ilians are desperate, but not defeated. Not yet. A small force of veteran fighters is left to defend Dag Marastir, with Captain Witherell among them, with all the remaining forces retreating to the war capital of Thalamar. Dag Marastir, the last fortress of the Great Iron Chain, still in Ilion hands. This day was a long time coming, with the Isirians growing ever bolder, and their armies of undead even stronger. But the swiftness of the attack surprised even the seasoned soldiers now defending the fortress in a desperate effort to at least delay the inevitable. Among them, Captain Witherell, formerly commander of Dag Forom, now another of the few remaining defenders of this last defense against the Isirians.
Captain, you're awake. Well, that was quite a blow. Fortunately, Gerard here managed to drag you inside. Commander Devana wants to see you as soon as you're ready. She's over there by the maps.
Thank you. Captain, it's good to see you are still with us. Getting out of Daeg Forome unscathed is a feat, but that doesn't make you immortal. The situation is bad. Really bad. Get yourself ready. We'll have to leave soon. This battle is lost. Oh, and one more thing. Make sure to talk to Hellebore.
To see you're back among the living. Anything I can help you with? I see. She's set on her plan. Here, take these. You will need them.
Captain, ready to move out? Okay, here's the deal. There's a second exit. But it will be hard. We can't evacuate everyone unless we take some control of the battle outside. That task falls on you, Captain. But he will not be alone. Either me or Rosha will assist you. Don't worry. She's a skilled lancer. I trust her as much as I trust myself. One of us will have to lead the survivors through the caves. It's a dangerous path and one that, for obvious reasons, only few people know. The choice is yours. Very well, everyone. Let's move out.
Thank you. Captain, I can't tell you how good it is to see you. That was my fault, Captain. We never expected the walls to crumble so quickly.
Captain, allow me to interrupt. I overheard the Azirians talking. They're waiting for reinforcements from Daeg Forum. We don't have much time.
Then we must hurry and get everyone to safety. And let you fight the Azirians alone? Not happening, Captain. And it's Christian. Let me be the judge of my skills and how to best put them to use, Captain. Everyone, move out to the fortress. Someone will guide you from there.
As you approach the entrance, the ground boils under your feet, spirals of smoke rising to the sky in contorted shapes. The air itself echoes with voices of pain and suffering.
Cursed land, right at the entrance. This is meant to trap any possible survivors in. What's a few dead soldiers to an army led by necromancers? Just fuel for the fire. Alive or dead, they will serve.
To see you. I went after a pair of Izerian soldiers. Thought they were an easy win. I don't know what they had planned for us, but I'm sure it wasn't good. Another exit.
The wizard pauses for a second, as if trying to recover a long-lost memory. And then his mood grows darker.
Oh, I see. If that's the point we're at, very well. But that path is not for me to take. Oh, no, not at all. I was just hoping we didn't get to that point yet. And not ours, I presume. Yes, saving people's lives is the best way forward. And with more Izerians coming, the fortress will surely fall. I see your point, Commander. But I would like to join you. There's still some fight left in me. Great. Let me direct everyone to the fortress, and I'm ready.
Thank you.
with the last Azarian soldier lying dead at your feet. The strange artifact at the center of the camp begins pulsating a strange blue light. Is it a warning? Is it a call?
Taking great care of your capital. It will make a wonderful Azarian city soon.
Commander Malat. Not a face I expected to see again, but the Nine did bless me with another chance, and I intend to make full use of it. Commander Malat was leading the catapult groups in the assault on Erevrond. be! You are dead! I killed you myself!
For an Izarian, death is but a fleeting moment.
The orders were clear. To evacuate you to Thalamar if the fortress gets under attack. We'll hold them off for as long as possible. I'm sorry, Captain, but once you plunged into battle, we had to improvise. The path through the caves is indeed safe, but the only exit is on the other side of the mountain. Who cares for a few more refugees in all this mess? The Azirians won't give them a second thought. They should be okay. Except for this guy here. But I have a surprise for him.
Your journey from Daeg Merisdir takes you through the forest of Nurdunas. You set up camp near the road to the great city, 2 days full riding left ahead of you. After the fall of Daeg Forom, a fortress that was under your command, you did not expect Daeg Merisdir to share the same fate so quickly, let alone to be called back to Thalamar. And yet, Chancellor Waldemar has requested your presence to discuss a matter of the utmost importance. Or so he says. The bonfire crackles lazily in front of you, and the woods are silent. Perhaps too silent. Anya, the scout sent ahead by Commander Divana, was supposed to meet you here, but she hasn't showed up yet. Where is she? She should have been back by now. Your companion, Christian, echoes the same worrying thoughts in his eyes. The crisp night air mixed its forest-laden fragrance with the smell of burning wood and hung around the two travelers like a cloak. The night was calm and relaxed, in complete contrast with the look on their faces.
She should have been here by now, Captain. This doesn't feel right. Anya is never late. Yes, true. But perhaps she can't. Maybe she was ambushed? Very little. This is the first time I've traveled this far north in my life. North of where we are right now, that's all I know. Aye, Commander. We should be very careful, though, just in case she's right about these goblins.